Hello everyone, welcome back to Legally Blind and to my new video. Today I'm going to take you through how I manage to use the computer with my particular visual impairment. And I'm still working on that video that I promised in my introduction, the one that will show you what the world looks like to me. But it turns out that one is going to take a bit more time to make, so I'm going to do this instead today. So right from the get-go, you can see that I have my setup so that my laptop is connected to an external monitor and also to USB keyboard and mouse. I do have speakers in the back there. I hardly ever use my laptop screen because it's too small for me and it's also a little dark. Although I do love this particular laptop, I'm using a Lenovo ThinkPad. It's a very, very good computer. I just don't like the display on the laptop. So I'm always connected to this external monitor, which I like very much. And without further ado, let me take you through how I magnify things on my computer. All right, so this is what your desktop will look like when you first start up. I usually have a black background because it makes it easier for me to see my icons. The first thing I would have to do in order to be able to use the computer at all is to hit the window and the U buttons, and that will open up the ease of access center on your PC. There's an equivalent on iOS, but I have no idea what it's called. Sorry about that, I only use PC. And then I will open up this magnifier by double clicking. And because of this is my default, it will immediately open up this bar on top of the screen. And everything inside this bar is magnified 4 times because that's what I've set it to. You can also set it up in a way so that the magnifier opens automatically when you open Windows. I just wanted to show you how to open it. And the way it works, as you can see, is that the magnifier follows my mouse. I move the mouse to read the sentence. And the mouse in the magnified portion of the screen stays in the center. I like this mode a lot because I can still see the whole screen and kind of navigate where I am on the screen and still be able to flip between looking at the magnified portion and looking at the big picture, depending on what I need to do. But there are also other modes. If you go here, you can also just close the ease of access center. That will not close the magnifier. Here is the magnifier icon on your taskbar. And up here, you see that you can change the magnification, or you can change what kind of mode you're in. This is called the docked mode, but there's also a lens mode, which I don't like very much. Or you can flip to the full screen mode by hitting the Control, Alt, and F buttons, and now you have full screen. I only use this mode when I'm reading. Most of the time, I stick with the docked view. And up here, you can change some of the settings as well. I always have it follow the keyboard focus because that means that when I'm typing, the bar follows my typing without me having to move the mouse, which is extremely important. Otherwise, I would never be able to see what I'm writing. And you can also invert the colors, which I will show you in a second. Down here is where you can choose whether the magnifier starts when you log on to Windows. I really like this docked view because it's really versatile. You can change the size of it like this. You can drag the whole thing out and move it to one side of the screen or the other. Right, left, to the bottom. Most of the time I leave it up top and just change the size of it depending on what I'm doing. And it's great because you can still have the magnification while keeping a wide view of what's on your screen. I usually invert the colors if I'm reading. So let's open this PDF file. You can just read like this, or you can invert the colors, which I like to do because it's more comfortable for my eyes. But I don't like having part of the screen inverted and part not inverted, so I usually read actually in full screen mode like this. hitting Control Alt F again. And just read like that. You can see right away that the one of the drawbacks of reading with this magnifier is the shaking. Although I think this will probably be the case with most screen magnifiers. It's not very comfortable on the eyes to keep your eye in one place and move the text. It's usually much more comfortable if you're reading a book or a hard copy of something. What usually happens is you move your eye onto a static object as opposed to keeping your eye fixed and moving the text. That's not very comfortable. I still get eye strains and eye strain headaches and sometimes even migraines if I have to use the computer for long periods of time and read for long periods of time. But I'm not really complaining because this magnifier makes it possible for me to actually use the computer, so not too bad. Let's get the colors back to normal here. Okay. On to browsing now. This is my Firefox window that I've opened here, and you'll see what I mean right now by following the text. If I type into this box, it'll follow my text, so I can actually see what I'm writing at all times. You'll also see that I prefer to have a dark background with light text when I'm browsing, and I do that with an add-on, which you can download in a minute. It's a Firefox add-on, and you can disable it, and it will go back to the regular Google colors, or hit the default, which will switch back to the enabled mode. So that's one way to get around the fact that your magnifier will only invert colors in the magnified portion of the screen. There's also another way to invert colors by going back to your ease of access center. Down here, this option that says make the computer easier to see will show you that there is a so-called high contrast mode. When you activate that mode, which you do by hitting left alt, left shift, and print screen, it will, there you go. It'll change everything inside your Windows to this mode. So you can even do that with Excel. Click and type anything into these cells. There will be this yellowish color on a dark background. A lot of people find this very comfortable. A lot of visually impaired people prefer this. I recently prefer this as well. Same thing goes for this Word document here. It'll follow my text and it'll be light text on a dark background. But I don't like this mode because, as you can see here in the magnified portion of the screen, it blurs everything a little bit. The resolution kind of goes out the window once you're in that mode. So I prefer not to use that mode, and instead, if I want that extra comfort for my eyes, I will go for the full screen mode and then invert the colors. And here you go. And I can keep typing like this. Yay! There are other things I like to do to make the computer easier for me to use. One of them is this. So, if I've lost my pointer and I don't know where it is, all I have to do is hit the control key and it does these concentric circles which tell me where my pointer is. You can activate that option by opening your mouse settings and going to pointer options, and down here, all the way down, there's this option that you have to tick that says show location of pointer when I press the control key. And there you have it. All right, so that's it for showing you things on my desktop. Other things I do to make my life easier when I'm using the computer is to obviously type without having to look at the keyboard, which is something you can teach yourself very easily online these days. I learned that when I was 12 years old, so it's never a problem for me. Of course, there are much more sophisticated magnification software programs out there, but for me, this is enough for my visual impairment. I have tried things like JAWS and Zoom Text, but I find them a bit too complicated, especially something like JAWS is actually designed for people who are completely blind, so it really was not practical for me. Although if you ask me what am I missing, I would say I would really like a very easy to use screen reader. And by easy to use, I literally mean that I should be able to highlight some text, right click and hit speak, and it should speak. So far, I have not found anything like this on PC, at least nothing that is free. If you are aware of a software that does this, something that is good and doesn't read like a robot too much, please let me know in the comments. Maybe there is something that I'm not aware of. That's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe, especially if there are visually impaired people in your life who might be interested in this. Please let them know that this channel exists. I also just created my Patreon account and will leave the link in the description. It would be amazing if you can support me. I would be able to buy better lighting equipment, pay the rent, and so on. So, thanks again, and I'll see you next time.